What's up, YouTube? First off, I want to apologize. This video is going to go on late. I'd hoped to put it on earlier, but my camera was out of my possession all day. So, unfortunately, it's going to go up later. But anyway, let's get into this. First off, before I start anything, update on the Michael Crichton autograph that I bought on eBay yesterday. People are saying that it is, in fact, not auto-pen, and it is authentic, which that really makes me happy. Got it for $12.95. Just a great, probably my favorite and best autograph in my entire collection. For those of you that don't know, I'm a huge fan of Jurassic Park, the book, and all three of the movies. I'm trying to do actually a Jurassic Park autograph collection. I've got one in a frame. I've got three autographs for it so far. One's in a frame. It's John Williams, who did the music for the first two films. Other one is Mr. Don Davis, who did the music for the third film. And right here, the man that started it all, who wrote the 1999 novel, Mr. Michael Crichton. So, I mean, that's obviously probably the best addition to the collection, the man that started it all. Alright, and before I get to something else, this video is related to my World Trade Center collection. And before I get to my mail, I got mail, I had some updates, some stuff I've obtained in the past for the collection. First one is something I got from my grandmother. She took a photo outside the World Trade Center site in 2006, post 9/11. And there's just a fence that was around the site at the time. Just got tons of memorial cards on it. I see American flags in the picture. Just really sad to see. But the World Trade Center site made a lot of progress throughout the years. I think the site, they want to reopen it on September 11th of this year, I believe, or it's either this year or next year. I can't remember for sure. They got new buildings going up, a memorial fountain where the towers originally stood. They're going to have two fountains, actually. A museum. Really great what they're doing there. I've seen some of the pictures. And actually, Joe MLM did a video not too long ago of the site, so I was glad to see that. All right, next item, also from my grandmother, is a Vanity Fair of from November 2001, a post 9/11, the title 1 week in September special edition. I actually read this not too long ago. Great pictures in it. There's Mayor Giuliani at the he was mayor at the time. There's the remains of One World Trade Center. Obviously, that's a horrible photo to look at. Just all the horrible stuff. I like it opens up here on the cover. It's got firefighters. So it's a great magazine. If you ever see one on eBay, it's Vanity Fair, November 2001 issue. Great magazine. All right. And last item, recent edition from May 2nd of 2011 is when I added it. It's the local paper, and must I explain more? There's a title right there. So I'm going to say about that. All right. So now the main part of this video. To quote Special Ed from Crank Yankers.
I got mail! Yay! I got mail! Yay!
I got mail. Yay. Mail from Mike at the Autograph Network, one of my favorite YouTubers, and probably one of my favorite TTMers on YouTube. Has some video every night, sends out a lot of autograph requests, and I just love seeing all the stuff he gets in. He gets in some oddball stuff, and I just love that. I have a autograph page on Facebook, and he posts every day if he gets something, what he gets, and I just brings a smile to my face just to see some of the oddball stuff that he has. Actually, I sent out to one that he got of, it was Tyrus Wong, who's a Disney animator. That was a sweet autograph. And he's also got a site, theautographnetwork.com. Some of the addresses are free, and you can get some really nice addresses if you become a member. I can't even remember the exact price. I want to become a member one of these days when I scrape together a couple dollars. I will, because some, I think he got Vince Carter membership site on the membership site. I'm sorry, I'm at a loss for words. On the membership site, like some of the addresses, I think he's got Shaq, Vince Carter. Great stuff. I actually used the site recently for an address. All right, so as I said he was going to send me something for the World Trade Center PC. I'm not going to go through the letter, but I'll summarize it for you. He went to New York in 1999, actually on New Year's Eve, saw the ball drop in Times Square, which is sweet, something I've always wanted to do. And he sent me some pictures, two pictures, and I'll give you the description that he gave for each picture. He says, shot one, the New York skyline with the Trade Center in the distance. This was shot from the top of the Empire State Building. This is a really nice shot. It's kind of, I want to say this was like towards sunset, but you can see the Trade Center in the distance there. Also, if you look closely, you can see Ellis Island, the Statue of Liberty. Great shot. This is a shot that a lot of people saw on their television on 9/11. This, because a lot of the news stations had cameras fixed at the Empire State Building observation deck, zoomed in on the towers. So you may have seen. I also got a postcard with a very similar shot. It's actually on the postcard. It's behind the Empire State Building. So a really cool shot. And the next one I really love. This is looking up. This is in the World Trade Center Plaza, looking up at both the towers. Just a awesome shot. I really love that. I'm sorry. I get a little emotional when it comes to stuff like this. Mike, it's really appreciated. These are two great photos. I really, really appreciate it. Great addition to the collection. God, I love that shot looking up at the Trade Center. I love it. Mike, thank you very much. Also, got my first Michael Rhodes signature, which is sweet. That could be worth something in a few years. But, Mike, it's really, really appreciated. You are a great YouTuber. If you are not subscribed to Mike, please do it now. Great stuff. Thank you very much, Mike. It's really appreciated. Thanks for watching. See ya.
They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day?